Ariana Grande calls out her TikTok lookalike, and Demi Lovato's private Instagram account is allegedly exposed. Welcome to Reality, a segment where we report on multiple stories in a single video. Before I get into the stories, I just want to put out a disclaimer. Please do not send any hate to Ariana Grande, Paige Niemann, Demi Lovato, Selena Gomez, or anyone else involved in these stories. This video is simply meant to report on the news. Ariana Grande called out people who impersonate her on TikTok. In order to fully understand this story, we need to go back in time. In November 2019, TikTok star Paige Niemann went viral when an Ariana fan account reposted one of her videos on their Twitter page. Ariana replied to that tweet, "I just wonder why the cat voice dialogue. I am sure she is the sweetest sweet sweetheart for real, but it's definitely bizarre seeing people blend the two worlds, LMAO." For context, Ariana played Cat Valentine on the hit Nickelodeon show Victorious from 2010 to 2013. Many of the TikToks that impersonate Ariana use dialogue from the show. Another fan responded, "Literally every vid I see of someone trying to somewhat mimic you, it's always a connection with Cat Valentine instead of the actual you." Ariana simply replied, "Oof." Back to the present. On April 17th, filmmaker Jordan Firstman made a comedy video on Instagram where he did an impression of a meme.
"What if we we took a moment, a small clip from a movie or a TV show, something that an artist really poured their soul into, and it just took them years to make, and it was an uphill battle the entire time. What if we took a moment from that and we kind of recontextualize it? Does that make sense? And we put a completely arbitrary meaning onto that thing that the artist loves so much, kind of degrading its entire value. I just think that could be kind of a fun thing to do." And I'm so bored. I just kind of want to ruin someone's life today. And then whoever can just say it's theirs. Anyone can just steal it then. That could be fun, right?
On April 23rd, Ariana reposted the video to her Instagram story and wrote, "OMG, can this please also double as your impression of the ponytail TikTok girls who think doing the Cat Valentine voice and that wearing winged eyeliner and a sweatshirt is doing a good impersonation of me? Cause this really how it feels, degrading its entire value. I screamed." The Instagram story was later deleted. Many people supported Ariana. Ariana did not hesitate to throw shade. "We stan. It's so weird how obsessed they are with her. She did what she had to do. It's weird. She's literally stealing her identity. I don't care." Later that day, Paige Niemann went live on TikTok and discussed the situation.
"I'm used to Ariana shading me, so...
yeah,
it's...
whatever.
I'm just here to entertain people, it's not how
true.
I really am in real life."
"I mean, you don't care."
"Kind of why I'm not a fan of her anymore, honestly. I'm slowly getting rid of all my Ariana stuff."
It's clear that Paige doesn't mean harm from her TikTok videos, but that doesn't stop Ariana from feeling hurt. Whenever we make memes or impersonations of films, TV shows, or stars, it's always important to remember the humans behind the original work. Do you think Ariana overreacted, or do you think Paige should stop her impressions? Demi Lovato is in trouble for her alleged private Instagram account. In order to understand more about this story, we need to go back in time. Demi and Selena Gomez had been best friends from when they starred on Barney and Friends in 2001 until around 2010. While it's not clear what happened between the two stars, Demi hinted at the state of their friendship a few times in 2010. In January 2010, Demi was signing autographs in London when a fan asked her how Selena was. Demi replied,
"I'm Taylor."
In June 2010, Demi spoke to teen magazine Girls Life about her friendship with Selena, saying, "We're both busy and I wish the best for her. True friends don't let their friends or family be mean to you. If you can't trust somebody, you can't be friends with them. However, in 2011, after Demi left rehab, she said Selena had been there for her. She called me crying when I was in there and was just so worried. I was like, look, I should be the one crying, it's all good. But she was so worried, and ever since then, we've gotten closer. In 2013, Demi told Live from MTV that while she and Selena didn't talk every day, they were still in each other's lives. We've been through a lot together. We've had periods of times where we grew apart and we just didn't really talk. Now we are in a place where I think we realize that life is so short, and that when you have people in your life that love you so much, then you should just always be around them. Everything about her, she has a great soul, she's talented, she's beautiful, and she will always be really, really close to my heart. In 2014, fans noticed that Demi unfollowed Selena on social media. During an appearance on Watch What Happens Live, Demi said,
I think it's just one of those things where people change and people grow apart.
But in 2015, Demi re-followed Selena, and they both tweeted positive things about each other. In an interview with ET, Selena said she was like family at this point. Demi and Selena seemed to be on good terms until 2018, when Demi unfollowed several people, including Selena, after her overdose. According to ET, she did it to focus on herself and avoid any difficult relationships. Then, in January 2020, Selena posted on her Instagram story about Demi's Grammys performance, where she sang Anyone, a song Demi had recorded 4 days before the overdose. Selena wrote, I wish there were words to describe how beautiful, inspirational, and deserved this moment was. Demi, I'm so happy for you. Thank you for your courage and bravery. Fast forward to April 2020. On April 14th, the magazine Harper's Bazaar posted their cover story with Demi. In the candid interview, Demi spoke about Selena's Instagram story and the state of their friendship. Here's a quote from the interview. According to Lovato, she's not currently close with Selena Gomez either. The two were inseparable in their early Disney years. Gomez, though, posted a supportive Instagram story after Lovato's performance at the Grammys. When you grow up with somebody, you're always going to have a love for them. But I'm not friends with her, so it felt... Lovato stops herself. I will always have love for her, and I wish everybody nothing but the best. On April 17th, the drama grew when several Twitter users posted a collage of screenshots from Demi's alleged Finsta account. A Finsta is short for fake Instagram, an account where someone will post photos they only want specific people to see. The first screenshot in the collage is a post that shows a screenshot of the iTunes singles chart with Demi's song Anyone at number one. The account, Trauma Queen Forever, captioned the post, Number one, baby, ah! The second screenshot is of a comment on the iTunes post. The comment said, You didn't even have to go to Walmart and buy your own copies. That's what the I'm talking about. Trauma Queen Forever replied, ha 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 ha, savage. For context, Selena was called out for buying multiple copies of her album at different stores in order to try and get the number one spot on the Billboard album chart. The third screenshot is a post that shows a screenshot of the section in Demi's Harper's Bazaar interview where she spoke about Selena. Trauma Queen Forever captioned the post, I really did try to keep my mouth shut, I swear. The fourth and fifth screenshots show pictures of Demi posing with a signed copy of People magazine, with Demi and Selena on the cover. Demi signed her name over Selena's face. Trauma Queen Forever captioned the post, You can call me Petty LaBelle. The last screenshot was of a photo that appeared to show Demi, Selena, and Nicki Minaj sitting together. The post was captioned, And this would never happen. Hashtag Photoshop. Someone also posted a screen recording of a live video from the account as proof the person behind the account is really Demi. And gossip blogger Perez Hilton shared a screenshot from the account that showed a picture of Demi and a friend, and the caption, which included the N-word. Once the collage started going viral, the hashtag Demi Lovato is over party started trending. However, there is a lot of debate over whether the account and the posts were real. Matthew Scott Montgomery, one of Demi's close friends, replied to a tweet about the alleged Finsta. Wait, what? This is fake. One person replied to Matthew's tweet with a screen recording showing he was following the account. A Twitter user also pointed out that many of Demi's celebrity friends followed Trauma Queen Forever, but several people said the account was real, but the posts themselves were fake. Another Twitter user made a thread showing how they took several posts from Lady Gaga's Instagram, put them in a collage, and lowered the brightness. The final results look similar to the Trauma Queen Forever collage. Someone replied to the thread asking about the spacing on the iTunes screenshot and the desktop scroll-through arrows on a screenshot that looked like it was taken on a mobile device. Regarding the scroll through arrows, the original poster said the screenshots were taken on a Google phone. Several fans who believe the posts are fake pointed to an alleged Selena fan account that claimed to make the edit. However, one Selena fan said the account actually belonged to a Demi fan who made the account after hashtag Demi Lovato is over party started trending and was trying to clear Demi's name. Other people who believe the posts and account are real shared screenshots from Demi's Instagram story back in May 2019. Where she posted the photo that was later used as the Finsta profile photo. At first, Demi and Selena did not officially respond to the situation, but a source close to Demi told Insider there were several fake and edited posts circulating on social media. It's unfortunate that people are finding time to attack others when the world has far bigger issues to focus on at the moment. However, Demi turned the comments off on a photo she posted on Instagram the day before the screenshots went viral. She has since turned the comments back on. And people noticed Trauma Queen Forever started removing all their followers, and the account changed their name to Dolphins Forever 02, and their profile picture to a black circle. As well, fans said the account deleted 9 posts. It's unclear what the deleted posts are, but people seem to think they include the posts that were allegedly leaked. However, on April 24th, Demi was interviewed on Jamila Jamil's I Weigh podcast, where she talked about being canceled. While she didn't address any specific allegations about the Finsta, she talked about hashtag Demi Lovato is over party and how she felt when the hashtag started trending. I've been canceled so many times that I can't even count. Like, the hashtag Demi is over party, like, that whole thing is just like, it doesn't even affect me anymore. She also spoke about the need for a forgiveness culture. Where is the forgiveness culture? You know what I mean? Like, I do, to a certain degree, there are some people that are just, if you have used up your second and third chances with a certain topic, you're canceled, and you should stay canceled. But if you mess up and you apologize, and you come forward and you say, I've learned from this, then let that be an example for other people so that they can change too. Unless Demi says the account and the posts were hers, we'll never know for sure if they were real or not. But regardless, this situation is an important reminder to be kind to others, especially to people you disagree with. We may never know what really happened to Demi and Selena's friendship, and until they speak about their past, all fans can do is support their favorite artist and respect the other person. Do you think the account and posts are real? What do you think about these stories? Let me know in the comments below.